Hi guys, welcome to PM Coding Tutorials. In today's video, I will show you how to create this CSS animation neon text glow. So, let's get started. To begin with, I have my folder called Tutorial open in Visual Studio Code. I am creating an index.html file and I am just quickly adding some basic code, changing the title and linking the style sheet. I'll also create the style sheet now to have it out of the way. For the text, I will quickly create an SVG with Figma, a free online tool. To follow along, head over to figma.com, where you can create an account and use it free of charge without having to install anything. I'm already logged in and I have a blank file open. Creating the SVG is very simple. All we need to do is type in the text. I will make it bigger so you can see it. However, the size will be controlled with CSS, so you don't need to change it here if you don't want to. Then I will make some minor adjustments. As the font, I am setting nothing you can do, but you can change this to another one if you like. Then I am also increasing the letter spacing to leave more space for the neon shadow between each letter. Finally, I am turning off the fill and adding a stroke. The stroke width I am decreasing to 0.1. The text is not really visible here anymore, but it will be on the website. Now that this is done, I can right-click and copy the text as SVG. Going back to the HTML file, I am pasting in the SVG. It is quite long, so you might get this message popping up if you are also using the same code editor. I am going to scroll up to the top because there is one thing we need to change, and that is removing the width and the height attributes. I will control these properties with CSS instead. This is all the HTML we need. Let's do the styling now. First, I am resetting all the styles by selecting each element with the asterisk selector and then applying a padding and a margin of 0. Next, I will set the background image on the body. First, I am changing the height of the body to be the full height of the page with 100VH. As the background color, I am setting black in case the background image we'll set next doesn't work. For the background image, I am using a photo taken from Pexels. I will link it below if you would like to use the same one. Then, the background should not get repeated. It should be centered, and it should cover the entire area. For the SVG, I want to have a width of 900 pixels. I am setting the fill to white and I want to position it in the center of the page. For this, I am giving it the position absolute so I can remove it from the regular document flow. Then I am positioning it 50% from the top and the left. Finally, I am using transform, translate and passing in -50 and -50%. This will center the SVG perfectly. Let's have a look. I am starting my Live Server plugin, which automatically opens the project in the browser and reloads the page anytime I save changes. Now we only need to create the animation for the glow effect. For this, I am adding a add keyframes rule and I am naming the animation animate. You can change the name if you prefer. I'll paste the code in to save a bit of time. So basically, we have a start position at 0% and an end position at 100%. The styles added under 0% will show at the very beginning and the styles under 100% at the end of the animation. For the shadow, I added a filter and specified several drop shadows to build the neon effect. So the first two values, in this case 0 pixels and 0 pixels, are the x and y coordinates. Then the third value is the blur. For the first two white ones, the blur is quite small to make it more intense. And as the color becomes darker, the blur increases. At 100%, each of these blurs is increased, which results in the growth of the neon shadow. With this done, we only need to assign the animation to the SVG. I'll achieve this by adding four properties. Animation name, animate. Animation duration, 0.8 seconds. You can change the value and make it go faster or slower. Animation direction, alternate. This way the animation will play from the start to the end and then from the end to the start and so on. Finally, we add the animation iteration count to infinitive so it keeps repeating endlessly. Let's look at the results. Here we have the finished project. If you have any questions, please leave a comment below and I'll try to answer. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please subscribe for more CSS and JavaScript tutorials. If you built your own version of this project, feel free to share it in the comments. I would be happy to see what your take on it is. Thanks for watching, and until next time!